There's another allegation of sexual misconduct against an NDP MP, but this time it's against the MP who raised allegations against a caucus colleague earlier this year. Christine Moore will be suspended from caucus duties pending the outcome of an investigation into her conduct with a veteran under treatment for post-traumatic stress disorder. This comes just days after her former NDP colleague, Erin Weir, was ejected from the caucus following an investigation into proper behavior, which Moore instigated in February. NDP leader Jagmeet Singh suspended Moore from her caucus duties this morning, pending that full investigation into the allegations she plied this veteran with alcohol, followed him to his hotel, and sent him explicit text messages. Christine Moore issued a statement following her suspension, which said in part that I welcome the opportunity to participate in the independent and fair examination of these allegations. Out of respect for the fairness and integrity of the process, I will not be commenting further on these allegations at this point. And veteran Glen Kirkland joins us from Brandon. Glen, I know this is difficult to talk about, but can you describe what happened following that parliamentary committee meeting with Christine Moore?
Well, I don't want to get into too much detail, but there was some inappropriate conduct by the member of parliament, and I was requested to go back to the member's office and proceeded to serve up a couple cocktails. And the reason I went back there in the first place is that she mentioned that she was a registered nurse and by trade, and that she was going, she could take a look at my medications and stuff and see if there's anything that she could do.
But it was clearly designed that she must have had a personal interest in you, and yet it ended up as a sexual relationship. But did you feel pressured into sex? Did you feel pressured into doing something you didn't want to do?
Well, I'm definitely not on here like claiming rape. Like that's definitely far from it. I will say that I believe that Ms. Moore used her position of authority very inappropriately, and if the genders were reversed, and if I was a female who just did a big emotional testimony, and if a male MP acted the way that she did, I really feel like this would be quite a bit different conversation. And the hypocrisy of this, with her coming forward and being the self-appointed voice of ethics when it came to Mr. Weir's situation, I just find it quite disturbing.
And it didn't stop there. I mean, I gather she randomly showed up a couple of times unannounced in your future. That must have seemed very odd to you. Did you not say, look, this isn't the relationship I want, it's not happening?
Yes, I'm pretty sure verbatim I used those words. And unlike Mr. Singh's kind of announcement about Weir's not, there was very much more than nonverbal cues being given to her. And again, like participation in kind of trying to court me, I guess, I don't know how else to describe it, was very inappropriate just because of her position as a member of parliament and mine as a serving member in the military. I truly would not have been in that position if she wasn't a member of parliament.
And you were also being treated for post-traumatic stress disorder, which was the reason you were in Ottawa to begin with. Was that a mitigating factor here? Did you feel that condition was at all worsened by this encounter at all?
I wouldn't say that. It was like, I want to make sure that people are aware, I'm not coming forward about this. Everyone knew about this right from day one. I'm just answering the questions now. Like, I'm not benefiting anything from this, nothing. I just, when I heard about Weir's situation, I felt like I could answer the questions, because especially coming from Ms. Moore herself, I just felt just being so ironic. But did my post-traumatic stress have anything to do with this? Well, I don't think so. Like it, no. I'm going to say probably no.
As the party has since suspended her from caucus duties, they're going to launch an investigation into what went on. Have you been contacted by the party? And if you are, will you cooperate with their investigation?
No, I have not been contacted. And again, like, I'm not coming forward with these allegations. Like, there's been an article written about this years ago in some satirical magazine out in Ottawa. This has been common knowledge, not just with different media sources, but also with members of parliament from all parties. So will I participate? It depends, but like everything's out there, and like I haven't done anything wrong, and I just feel like I don't think this would have been an issue if she didn't take that self-appointed ethical role.
All right. Glen Kirkland, appreciate you coming forward, talking to us at least. Even though the story's a bit old, it certainly is an interesting time to be bringing this forward. Thanks very much for your joining us today.
Thanks for having me.